get you on a swivel.
Welcome everyone. On behalf of Sheriff Ronnie Lawson, each person here at the Hawkins County Sheriff's Office, to our fallen officers' memorial. This memorial is not only just for our officers of Hawkins County, it's also for each officer that has ever fallen across this great nation that we live in. The presentation of the colors is going to be presented by the Hawkins County Sheriff's Office Tactical Unit. The national anthem will be sung by one of our own retired Lieutenant E. Jackson. The invocation will be delivered by our own chaplain, Reverend Rick Dinkins. If everyone would please rise for the presentation of the colors.
Detail, okay. Hard.
Bow our heads and pray.
Heavenly Father, as we come into your presence today to remember and memorialize the courage and the dedication and the professionalism of the fallen officers who have served and protected their communities, and especially these who have fallen in serving our community. God, we ask that you would bring your peace and your comfort upon us. God, we need an inner strength and we need a guidance that can only come from you. And we ask, God, that you would wrap your arms of compassion about the family members that are here with us today. God, that you would undergird them with your courage and your strength. We ask, God, that you would give us of your peace, of your protection, and your care. And may everything that is said and done here today give you honor and glory. And may it be done to bring comfort and a spot of brightness, we pray, to the lives of this family. We ask this in Christ's name.
Order! Halt! Hooray! Rest!
Everyone please stand. Like I said, I want to thank you for coming again tonight. Sorry we had to move indoors. We were afraid that the thunderstorms was going to open up and drown us. So we have asked to come in, so we will not be having the 21 gun salute later on this evening. So just to let everybody know, Sheriff Lawson will now present the message.
Good evening. Thanks everyone for coming. Appreciate you so much. Again this year, communities across the United States will come together during National Police Week to honor and remember those law enforcement officers who make the ultimate sacrifice, as well as family members, friends, and fellow officers they've left behind. Family members and fallen officers, we welcome you all to the Justice Center tonight. We honor you here. I wish there was some way that I could help heal the pain that you all still feel. I guess the best way that I can help you is to say that we think about you often. We pray God will give you strength and comfort. I know you go through a lot. Every time you see on TV, you see a fallen officer, you bring back memories. We thank you for the sacrifice of your loved ones. We have a solemn obligation to give and credit to law enforcement officers who are no longer with us. We honor as well as the ones who hope so perfectly faced injury and disability across our great nation. We're so grateful to those who have retired after honorable careers, of course those who are on the job every day. At times, law enforcement seems to be the most thankless work that you could ever do. But I'm here to tell you that that's one of the greatest professional callings person can have. By taking an oath to serve and protect the fellow citizens, law enforcement officers answer a vital calling and accept a profound responsibility every day. These extraordinary Americans work to uphold our laws and serve on the front lines in the fight against crime and terrorism. It's sad to see how quickly America turned against law enforcement. They seem to forget who will give their life for someone that they don't even know. In 2017, 135 law enforcement officers died in the line of duty. This year, there's already been 53 officers died. That's four more than this time last year. We have three brave men made up for sacrifice in the past years in Hawkins County. Deputy German, Monroe Bubba Gibson, July 13, 2000. Bubba was shot and killed during a 13-hour standoff with a burglary suspect. Deputy John Wesley Wright, August 16, 1988. Observed Deputy Wright was accidentally shot and killed by another officer while assisting apprehension of a shooting convict. Deputy Drew Harrell, July 13, 1937, received in a vehicle assault. With these, we honor here today. We have made an open sacrifice, and the word thank you would never be enough for these officers. To the families, the friends, those who are here to honor today, we offer eternal gratitude for sharing your loved ones with us. For their special gift to serve and protect and follow us, we will always remember. May God bless you. May you protect those who are still serving across our great state and our great nation. God bless Tennessee. God bless the United States of America. Thank you.
With honor, the proclamation is going to be presented by the Honorable Gary W. Hicks, Jr., Tennessee State Representative.
Good evening. This is a proclamation proclaiming May 13th through 19th, 2018 as Police Week in Hawkins County, Tennessee. To recognize National Police Week 2018 and to honor the service and sacrifice of those enforcement officers killed in the line of duty while protecting the community of Hawkins County, Tennessee, and safeguarding our democracy. Whereas there are approximately 900,000 law enforcement officers serving in communities across the United States, including the dedicated members of the Hawkins County Sheriff's Department. And whereas there have been 58,627,000 assaults against law enforcement officers in 2016, resulting in approximately 16,677 injuries. And whereas since the first recorded death in 1791, more than 20,000 law enforcement officers in the United States have made the ultimate sacrifice and been killed in the line of duty, including three members of the Hawkins County Sheriff's Office. And whereas the names of these dedicated public servants, Deputy Sheriff Drew Harrell, Reserve Deputy John Wesley Wright, and Deputy Sheriff Gerald Monroe Gibson, are engraved on the walls of the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial in Washington, D.C. And whereas 360 new names of fallen heroes are being added to the National Law Enforcement Officers this spring, including 129 officers killed in 2017 and 231 officers killed in previous years. And whereas the Candlelight Vigil is part of National Police Week, which takes place this year on May 13th through 19th. And whereas May 15th is designated as Peace Officers Memorial Day in honor of all fallen officers and their families, and U.S. flags should be flown at half staff. A ceremony will be held at the Hawkins County Sheriff's Justice Center at 6 p.m. on May 15th, 2018, honoring fallen officers of the Hawkins County Sheriff's Department. Now, therefore, I, Gary Hicks, Jr., do hereby proclaim May 13th through 19th, 2018, as Police Week in Hawkins County, Tennessee, and publicly salute the service of the fallen law enforcement officers in our community and in communities across the nation. Thank you all very much.
We have our own chaplain with Hawkins County Sheriff's Office. He's going to be speaking with us, Reverend Rick Dinkins.
I would like to begin by saying thank you to the families of our fallen officers who have come to be with us today. This service is about you. I would also like to say thank you to the members of our community, especially the honored guests, our dignitaries who are here with us today. Thank you for taking time out of your busy and hectic schedules to come and join us in this memorial service. For our current serving officers, the men and women of Hawkins County Sheriff's Department, thank you for the service that you do and for being here today. And of course, for the administrative offices here in Hawkins County, we are very honored to have them and to be able to serve alongside them. The three that we are talking about today, as well as the other 50 plus who have given their life this year, are the reason why we're here today. These are the real heroes in our world. Today's society seems to be having somewhat of a difficult time identifying who the real heroes are in this world. We flock to movie theaters to watch things like The Avengers, Those are nothing more than fairy tales from the mind of some writer and movie producer. It has been said that only two defining forces have ever offered to die for you. One is Jesus Christ, and the other is the American GI. One died for your soul, and the other died for your freedom. I'd like to modify that statement today, if you would give me that liberty, and tell you that in fact there are three defining forces that have offered to die for you: Jesus Christ, the American GI, and the law enforcement officers. Jesus died for your soul. The American GI died for your freedom. And the law enforcement officers place their lives on the line every single day when they don the uniform. Many of them have paid the ultimate price with their lives in order to provide for you and I the continued service and protection that we desire. These fallen officers we honor today are truly the real heroes of our world. There has never been such a time where the expectation for so many to be willing to give their life for so many who seem to care so little like there is today. In fact, if records are correct, and we checked just before we started this service, one officer gave his life today in Florida, making the total 54 officers who have paid the ultimate price, serving and protecting communities. These three that we honor today have given their life to serve this community and offer to you and I the protection that we need and deserve. And to them we say thank you, and to you we say thank you. God's word said that greater love hath no man than this, that a man would lay down his life for his friends. These men and women who are our true heroes are the bravest of the brave. They are brave not because they do not have fear. They are afraid at times. But they are brave, and their bravery comes in action in the face of fear. Yes, these men and women are human. They are just like you and I. They have the same fears. They have the same concerns. They have the same emotions as each and every one of us. These heroes put on their pants just like we do, one leg at a time. They love their families, and their families love them. Many have sacrificed the safety of their own family to give safety and protection to your families and to the families of others. They have sacrificed the time with their families in order to spend time protecting your families. And these who are sitting here on the front row, you're carrying a burden of grief because at one time you expected an officer to return home, and that shift never ended. These are our true heroes. There are those today who would complain about the work of the police officer or the law enforcement officer. Some would say that law enforcement has become too militarized, too much like the military. But my friends, these men and women are not coming up against the Otises of the Andy Griffith Show. This is real life. They are facing criminals who are often outgunning the officer. They are facing officers who are unwilling to comply to officers' demands. These criminals are harsh. It's not a TV show. It's not even a reality show. It is reality. Sometimes we get upset about the tax dollars that are spent to buy the equipment that is needed for our officers. But may I take this moment to remind you that the officers' equipment that is purchased with your tax dollars provides you safety as well. These men and women have answered a call in their life to stand in the face of evil. One man said they are sheepdogs, and they are. Some people do not like sheepdogs. They say they look too much like the wolf. Some even say at times they act like the wolf. And Friedrich Nietzsche once said that whosoever fights monsters should see to it that in the process he does not become a monster himself. But I want to share with you today, having been alongside these officers, these men and women are not striving to become monsters. They are not desiring to become wolves. But I must remind you also, there is no pretty way to fight evil. No one likes the sheepdog until the wolf is at the door. And these men and women, our true heroes, will show up when the wolf is at the door. They will put their life on the line, even for those who oftentimes criticize them. These heroes that we memorialize today, and the men and women of Hawkins County Sheriff's Department, are the men and women just like you and I. But when evil knocks at the door, they do not run. In fact, they rise to the occasion. They face their fears, and they get the job done. They walk among us, and they look like us, but make no mistake, they walk among the sheep, but they are the sheepdogs. And they will fight and face evil. They're here to protect you, to honor those who have fallen before them, and because they have answered a call of God on their life. You see, the Bible says in Romans 13, 1 through 4, let every soul be subject unto the higher powers, for there is no power but of God. The powers that are ordained of God, and whosoever therefore resisteth the power, resisteth the ordinance of God. And they that resist shall receive to themselves damnation. For the rulers are not a terror to good works, but to evil. Wilt thou then not be afraid of the power? Then do that which is good, and thou shalt have praise of the same. For he is a minister of God to do thee good. But if thou do that which is evil, be afraid. For he beareth not the sword in vain. For he is the minister of God, a revenger to execute wrath upon him that doeth evil. Again today, some 54 officers this year have laid down their lives in service to their community. And these three that we honor here today have done the same. To you who are here as members of their family, Duke, brother officers and sister officers, and to anyone in this community whose lives have been touched by the loss, we have this vigil and this service for you. I know that there is nothing, as the sheriff has already indicated, that can be said that can ease your pain. But we hope that by honoring and remembering your fallen loved ones, that we can place in your heart just a little bit of our gratitude. The word vigil literally comes from a Greek or a Latin word that means wakefulness. It means literally a period of purposeful sleeplessness. And that is, in a sense, why we're here. To refuse sleep, and to refuse to forget the heroes that have given their lives and still yet not completed the work. The work of fighting against evil, wickedness, and crime is still underway. And though we grieve, we reject despair. We are not beaten. We still have the fortunate many who come and are heroes with us today, these men and women of the Hawkins County Sheriff's Department. They carry on the legacy of these three men and continue their work. Though we grieve, we reject despair. We remember and value the lives of those who have fallen. In his work, Common Sense, Thomas Paine wrote these words. He says, and I quote, "The harder the conflict, the more glorious the triumph. What we obtain too cheaply, we esteem too lightly." These have paid, your loved ones have paid with their life. You who survive carry a great and heavy burden of grief. But we remember with glorious triumph their life, their work, and the love that they shared. These are real heroes. We live in a world that employs the term hero far too loosely. We overuse it many times, talking about movie stars, actors, athletes, and while they may have some skill or talent, and even at times may engage in some kind of heroic effort, they're not the true heroes. As a parent, as a husband, a community leader, and a pastor. I have strived to teach well the honor and the respect that our officers deserve. And I join with you tonight, and I encourage you to continue to hold fast to the responsibility of remembering and honoring those who have passed, giving their life in service. I want you to know that they have not passed in vain. They will not slip into obscurity, and they will not be forgotten. I'm pleased to recognize the real heroes who are among us. Those who have stood and said, I can do that. Those who have answered the call and said, I will give more, and I will walk in harm's way so that you do not have to. As someone once said, most men have no purpose but to exist. They pass quietly through history as minor characters upon a stage they really cannot see, to be the playthings of tyrants. But these we honor here today are real heroes. The difference between a hero and a coward is that a hero will risk his own safety for the safety of others, while a coward will take your safety and even your life to gain something they do not deserve. To you, the officers who have fallen are of great importance. These men and women who serve in Hawkins County today are also of great importance. You follow in their footsteps. You are living in their legacy. And I challenge you to remember those who have gone before you and paved the way. In society today, it seems that we are oftentimes held to a higher standard. And maybe we should be. And no one is asking of you today to cut these who have fallen or any of these officers who are serving today any special kind of slack. But what we do ask is that you give them some sense of understanding. For the conditions in which they work, the split second moments in which they have to make life and death decisions, just give them that understanding. If you walk in the honor or the memory and the legacy of the officers who've gone before you, you must do as Lieutenant Grossman has said. If you want to be a sheepdog and walk the warrior's path, then you must make a conscious and moral decision that every day you will dedicate, equip, and prepare yourself to thrive in that toxic, corrosive moment when the wolf comes knocking at the door. These officers have made such a commitment. My prayer is today that God would bless you, this family, that there would be a constant remembrance of these men who have given their lives in the service of this community, and that we would continually and constantly uphold in prayer those officers who carry on their legacy and who continue to serve day by day. Again, thank you for being here. Let's close with a time of prayer. Lord, I thank you for the lives of these three men. And Lord, I know that they did not die in vain. God, they died in service, protection to this community, their work and their labor still being carried on by those who are faithfully serving today. Their lives still remembered. And God, their memory still being carried on in the hearts of family and friends that are gathered here today. God, we just ask that you would give protection to those who continue to serve, and that you would give comfort to the families, especially in their greatest time of need. God, you are the great comforter. You are also our great shepherd and protector. And so, Lord, we look to you for guidance and for strength. And in all this, we tell you thank you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Family of our fallen officers, I want you to know that we have three memorials placed at a certain place at our office, and that's the entrance that we use. So I want you to know that every day, each one of these officers who walks in and out of those doors. You can look, you can hide in the parking lot, you can watch them look down at those memorials. Your family has never been forgotten by us. They're our brothers, and we'll always bear our brothers. So at this time, we're going to have a roll call for our fallen brothers. Deputy Gerald Bubba Gibson. Deputy Gerald Bubba Gibson. Deputy Gerald Bubba Gibson.
Deputy Gerald Bubba Gibson. End of watch, July 13, 2000.
Deputy John Wesley Wright. Deputy John Wesley Wright. Deputy John Wesley Wright.
Deputy John Wesley Wright. End of watch, August 16, 1988.
Deputy Drew Harrell. Deputy Drew Harrell. Deputy Drew Harrell.
Deputy Drew Harrell. End of watch, June 15, 1937.
Every day, we will never forget our fallen brothers. Thank you for the sacrifice that they gave Hopkins County, Hopkins County Sheriff's Department, each citizen that we have in our great county. At this time, we have special music by Sheriff Hank. In honor of our fallen heroes, the Plainview Taps will be performed by Trooper James Nipper of the Tennessee Highway Patrol.
Detail, attention. Freeze, man.
Service, I'm on up and stand now. Please rise for the retiring of the colors.
Dismissed.
I want to thank everyone for coming tonight. I would like to say a special thank you for Christian Self Funeral Home once again that has helped us put this on. Due to the weather, Wings Air Rescue was not able to do a flyover. But family, I want you to know that your families will never be forgotten. You're more welcome to stay with us and speak. But everybody, please drive safely and thank you for attending. Everybody be safe going home. Thank you very much. Dismissed.
They'll be a first sweep book, I can't wait.
Thank you. You keeping him in line? Oh, I know, we try everybody. Actually, we tag team the coffee party.
I'm just taking a look.